David has asked, can you go more into the balancing? I've never heard about that before. I've built a lot of old muscle cars, but not anything like you are. I've never heard of this weighing, etc. Okay, yeah, good point there, David. So it is important to mention that when we are dealing with any factory engine, even the factory engines are balanced within the factory, and they're all going to be balanced to a certain tolerance. So it's not like the engines are unbalanced. Likewise, when we are buying quality engine components from aftermarket manufacturers, generally the pistons and connecting rods are balanced by the manufacturer across the set to make sure that they're within their certain tolerance. So even if we aren't doing any balancing work, we're still going to be dealing with components that have some degree of balance. Of course, there can be improvements to be made there by going the extra distance and getting that balance a little bit tighter within the tolerance that the factory or component manufacturer has designated. So the advantage there is we're reducing the vibration and harmonics that will be present while the engine operates, and this can, it normally isn't going to show up in additional power, but it can improve the reliability of our engine. It also makes the engine just operate smoother, and there's less vibration being transferred into other components of the chassis. Now, as I did mention there as well, if you are dealing with V configurations, engines, maybe V6, V8, etc., then the way the piston and conrod assemblies work inside the engine means that the weight of the piston and rod does need to be taken into account or factored in when the crankshaft is balanced, because those components are kind of accounted for by the counterweight balance or counterweight of the crankshaft. This becomes important as well if you are building a V8 engine, for example, and you're using a range of unmatched components. Quite often you're going to find that the crankshaft will not be matched to the mass of the pistons and rods that you've chosen. That can get a little bit tricky. Sometimes a lot of material needs to be removed from the crankshaft counterweights to balance that out, or worse still, if the crankshaft counterweights are too light, then heavy metal needs to be added into the counterweights, which can be quite an expensive process.
That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.